Yes. Maybe a few words on Inco. I realize I'm between you and the drinks, so I'll try to keep it short and precise. ICO is the International Church Organization for Development Cooperation, so not the International COCO Organization, which has the same abbreviation, I think. We work together with ACFO since, 2012 on flow, on the use of flow. And I will try to tell you a little bit about the process, what went well, what went not so well. So you might use that for your own organization as well. If you decide to start using flow as well. What basically happened is Mark Westra, one of the ACFO staff members, gave a presentation to ICO early 2012. And we had a little brainstorm on the possibilities on how to start using flow. And what we came up with, our organization has a number of regional offices worldwide. And basically our office in Indonesia, they were very, very willing to start using flow within our food security program. Within this program, we use basically a questionnaire, which is called the Havias questionnaire, which tracks the food security status of families. And what we do is we have a program from 2011 until 2015. We use it in the beginning as a baseline. This questionnaire, this survey among households. So we use it in the beginning in 2011. We use it in 2013 as a midterm report, so to say. And then in the end, in 2015 again, to track progress. So has the food security situation of communities, has it improved or not? Well, we were a little bit lucky that the baseline in Indonesia, it should have been taking place in 2011, of course, at the beginning of the program, but we didn't succeed to have it by then, so we could do it in 2012. So that was the lucky part, that the regional office there was willing to start up this process. And basically, the questionnaire consists of 9 questions, plus some additional household information. And you see a number of questions in the down on the screen, like questions like, did you sell your harvest? Was the price worse or better than last year? Those are the questions that are asked to those families. So the lucky part is these are really basic and simple questions that you can easily integrate into flow. And just to check, I think the audience, you are familiar with flow by now, right? Because we had a workshop earlier today. Many of you probably participated before in workshops. So most of you are aware with flow, right? Or just to cross-check? Okay. Well, what did we do? We did a training in Medan in Indonesia. And basically, ICO staff was involved, plus 2 of our partners. So we started really, really small, just to get experience with the application. And basically, I remember that we had quite a bit of discussion with Mark in the beginning, because ACFO was saying, you need a 4-day training. And we thought, okay, just to use an application on a smartphone, is it necessary to have a 4-day training? Basically, ACFO convinced us. And I have to admit, after the process, I think it was a good idea to have this 4-day training. I also have to say that nowadays we have some experience in other countries as well. Like 2 weeks ago, we had a similar training in Ethiopia with our partners. And now we are actually able to limit the time a little bit and do it a little bit quicker. Well, the good part about the training was it was very hands-on. So the people practiced with the phones like we did earlier today in the workshop. And what we realized is that some of our staff members never used a smartphone before. So that meant for the trainers, you really have to take some steps back. Like Heni, the lady in the middle in the photo, my colleague from Indonesia, she actually explained me by Skype, like, okay, the first time I know my son is able to use those things, but for me it's really it was really hard in the beginning. So you really need to take some steps back, and that's a challenge sometimes for the trainers, I think, to really start at the bottom level, like what is a smartphone. But basically, at the end of the day, we were able to use this pilot and now do about 300 interviews among the area that we are working. And this is one part that I particularly like as a geographer. I wanted to show you the map, of course. And now someone from ACFO should help me out, because I would like to show the little cards that usually pop up. Well, whatever. The nice part about the Flow application is not only you use the smartphone application, you track the geodata, which can be very helpful. And I'm convinced that in the future we are going to use this in one way or another. And basically also you can take the photos. So you not only get the data, you also have those two extra opportunities, which are basically great. We did have some questions about privacy issues, because you track information from private families. And obviously in the Netherlands, this would not be possible to publish this in Google Maps. We had quite a bit of discussion with Indonesia about that. And basically they said, currently this is still possible to do. But I think as an organization, we have to be careful and really make sure that we comply with laws in the countries that you are working. So now, how do I go back to the presentation? Help. I just close, yeah. So I thought maybe it's a good idea just to share from our point of view what kind of challenges that we had and what made it work. I think first of all, and I underestimated it a little bit in the beginning, because we had this discussion with Mark, and I thought in 2 months we are going to have Flow running. Well, it took a little bit more months, to be honest, because you need to have some organizational commitment. And luckily, our food security specialist within ICO was enthusiastic about the tool. And also the people in Indonesia were very enthusiastic. So that was the good part. And of course, we needed to have some budget. So we had to convince some of the management team members, of course, as well, to start using this tool. What was also very helpful is that we decided to have a pilot around a questionnaire that was basically a standard questionnaire with simple to answer questions. With a lot of yes/no answers, which made it a little bit more simple to put it in the application. Although we did have some discussions in Indonesia about the household questions that were asked, but basically there were simple questions. Then the language seemed to be a problem as well, but the people from ACFO were quite fast in making sure that we could use the tool in Bahasa as well, which gave us some problems in the beginning in the Netherlands, because of course we cannot read Bahasa, but then this problem was solved quite easily as well by having a bilingual option. So we can now see it in English and in Bahasa at the same time. And basically we had good infrastructure here in Indonesia. I understood from Ethiopia there were some issues with the 3G SIM cards 2 weeks ago, so they are looking into that. So sometimes there can be technical issues, of course. This is also an issue from Ethiopia. What they said there, the ones who are going to use the smartphone, they have a responsibility for it. Some people have doubts about phones that might get lost or stolen. Our experience so far is it's not that well. It's not bad at all. I didn't hear so far from phones that were being stolen. I know from other organizations it sometimes happens. So as an organization, you should think about how to deal with that. What we also said, and this is maybe the most important point. I think we really need a manual that makes us less dependent on ACFO. We have the idea to upskill, to use Flow in more countries. We want to be able to do this training ourselves. And therefore, we need a clear and good manual that we can use as a train the trainers concept, so to say. Then one other issue from Ethiopia, there were questions about the cultural acceptance of phones. People thought that people might be intimidated by interviewers with smartphones. The situation in Ethiopia was not that bad, but I can imagine in your own country or in other countries where you start working, you should think about this issue as well. And then basically the participants in Ethiopia, in Indonesia, at the end of the day, they said they really have a belief that the use of Flow lessens the workload. It does save money. Probably it reduces errors as well. And probably it increases the relevance of information as well, since you have this availability of photos and geo information. Well, one of the challenges I mentioned already, the smartphone or the ability to work with a smartphone of the participants. You really have to start at a low level. Well, sometimes we face technical issues, so you should take time for that as well. That's what we noticed in the training in Indonesia as well. The first day there were a lot of problems in solving some of the technical issues. The language, I told a little bit about that might be a challenge sometimes as well. And then we also had some issues about using the dashboard. Who is going to be able to use the dashboard within your own organization or with the partner organizations that you work with? You have to think about that. Is it do you allow access for everyone, or do you have specific persons in the organization that can control the dashboard? And unfortunately, we were hoping to use the 1.5 instance for this survey in Indonesia. So far, I know the people from ACFO worked really hard to upload the data, but unfortunately, I think yesterday evening they succeeded. So we didn't have enough time to include it in the presentation. But the dashboard, I have to say, it really looks better and simpler and more user-friendly than the old version that was slightly complicated, to be honest. So am I running out of time or I'm okay. So what we basically decided within ICO was to we are going to use Flow in more countries. Our food security program is in 12 countries. We now had the training in not only in Indonesia, but also in Ethiopia and in Uganda to do the midterm review, so to say. And we have plans to start working in Nepal, in Bangladesh, and in India, together with Amit from ACFO. And then Amit earlier this week had a discussion with Heni in Indonesia to start using Flow in our Fair Economic Development program as well. And then we have a client satisfaction instrument that we use in Malawi. And there we are starting to use Flow as well. So we are really in the process of trying to scale up Flow, and we will gain more and more experience in the coming years. And the fact that we are scaling up We do it because we are convinced this is going to work and will help us out with more and better data. And I think I'm through. Yeah, I have to say Amit wrote a very nice blog on the ACFO website after the training in Indonesia. So if you are curious to know a little bit more, you might approach him or either me. So thank you very much. Any questions?
Yeah, can you tell me something about how you reported back to the people that you interviewed? That's one. Another question I have is, can you tell me something about questionnaire fatigue, as I call it, because people are being questioned on everything and anything for all time. And also in that respect, did you ever notice that people give politically correct answers?
Okay. Well, the first question, reporting back, I have to be honest. I don't think, although we have a clear policy within within ICO that we are going to work more and more on downward accountability, I think the organization is still very much focused on the donors. And you see it back in those kind of pilots as well. Basically, our feature is to make reports about food security in this case, to make sure that we report back in a good way towards the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. And sometimes we tend to forget to report back in a good and proper way to the people that we interviewed. So no nice story there, to be honest. Secondly, fatigue of interviewing. I think in our situation is not that it's not that bad, because I think the communities that we start working with, for example in Indonesia, were quite new communities. Often they are happy that an organization such as ours is willing to start working with them. So there still was a good atmosphere to have those questionnaires done. Third question. Politically correct answers. I'm not able to answer that one, to be honest. So we should check with my colleague in Indonesia. I didn't have the feeling that this was happening, since this survey is very very straightforward. But I can imagine in other cases that this will happen. Yeah. Yeah. No more questions? Not allowed?
No, thank you very much.
Okay, thanks.